is up, party people? Back with another commentary. This will be take two. So I actually, so I work on my videos on my lunch break when I'm home. So I'm on my lunch break and finish the video, finish the commentary, and put a little music behind it. And for some reason, it didn't transfer. I was getting an error message. So come to find out, some of the files were corrupted when I was exporting them to iMovie, because that's where I used to edit my videos. And some of the clips, I think all the clips actually, somehow got corrupted. But anyway, it's whatever. Take two, here we go. So this is the third cycle of my training, Saiyan Strength and Aesthetics program. And this is phase three. Now, this phase, on this cycle, I'm starting to dive into weight that I have, not necessarily that I haven't used before, but the way that the program is structured, I've never done the amount of reps slash the amount of sets that I've done with the weight that I'm using. So I put up the numbers that I was using in the beginning of the video, and yeah, you know, I'm happy with how things are going. So like I said in my, I think it was my previous video, in December, I am going to be working with dudes from Massthetics. Very excited. Heard good things about it. Max Tuning, who I look up to, has them coaching him. So it's something different that I want to try. And, you know, it's very hands-on from what I gathered. You know, I send them videos and stuff like that. They critique form and whatnot. But it's cool that I have this YouTube channel, because maybe I can just send them over this way. But anyway, I'm happy, pretty happy with how everything is going. Like I was saying before, I am starting to notice as I put this video together that some of the movements are, my form break is breaking down a little bit, but it's gonna happen. Like I said, I've never really worked with the amount of weight, reps, and sets like in this program. So here's the missus. She was doing deads. Decided to record her. Put a little clip in here. She is doing 195 pounds, I believe. But moving on to bench, I gotta say, I think something is starting to click. So a few weeks ago, I was working with the same weight, but if you saw that video, you saw I needed help like a mofo, because my spotter was pretty much riding the bar. I could hardly get one rep or two reps by myself. Pretty pathetic. But here we have a little bit of redemption, which I'm happy about. Now, something I'm going to try that I've never done before is do benching on Tuesday instead of Monday. Now, the reason for that is because Sundays, sure, you've heard of Sunday Fun Day. Not that I go crazy with like drinking and eating out of control or anything like that, but I do notice I don't drink enough water. As far as like my micronutrients, I don't really hit them. It's pretty carb based. I hit my proteins. You know, I have my cheat meal. The food's there, but for some reason Mondays, I just kind of wake up feeling sluggish, even with my pre-workout and getting a decent night's sleep. So I pushed it to Tuesday to maybe kind of get back in the swing of things on Monday, and then by Tuesday I'll be fresh and ready and feel powerful. Here I was my last set and I was feeling fatigued, so I thought, fuck, better safe than sorry. So here we're doing some deads. This is my ritual before I pull every time. Kind of just, I feel, opens up my hips a little bit and just kind of gets everything a little bit fired and ready to go. And you are not crazy, these are actually sped up. I'm very happy with the way that my deadlifts are moving. I can definitely say though, after this was 345, 8 sets of 4, I was wrecked. Sunday, and today I'm still a little messed up. Downfall about recording on my lunch. Sometimes phone calls come in and I gotta start back up. But like I was saying, so on the program after deadlifts, it's a leg day, so usually I'll be doing like a leg press of some sort. Not of some sort, I do a leg press. But this gym, when I train, when we go to Jersey sometimes to visit the in-laws, I'll train at the gym in Jersey, and I fucking hate their leg press. So I decided to just do like low bar squats, only 135 pounds, did the same amount of reps and sets, so it was 4 sets of 12 on the leg press, so I just did 4 sets of 12 on low bar squat. And I think that's what did me in. I was just like, Sunday, my back, my legs, my neck and my back, everything was hurting. But like I said, I'm happy with the way deads are going. They move fairly well. Never really had an issue with it. Just wanted to get that 405, 10 sets of 3, man. We're getting there, we're getting there. Nice little booty shot. Now the last clips you're gonna see for the overhead press. So again, this is a different gym. Usually I will overhead press in the squat rack because the gyms I go to, they're commercial gyms. They don't have like power racks, and they just got like one squat rack. Usually somebody's on it. So to this day, I get there and there was a couple in the squat rack. You could see them in the background in this clip here. So they were on. They were there for about a little over an hour. So I got there right when they were starting, so I couldn't like work in or anything, and I didn't want to wait till they were done, cause Jesus, I would have been here all fucking day. So I said screw it, and just grabbed a barbell from the bench, did my working sets. Now I kind of like did a clean up into to get in a position, and I feel that it took not a lot of energy out of me, but it took a little bit of something. And for somebody who's trying to get their, you know, maximum output, I just want to be fresh and ready for every rep. So, but I feel like when I cleaned it up, I just took a little bit out of me, so it was a little bit of a struggle for us. Again, overall, happy with how the how I'm progressing with the overhead press. Just trying to remember cues when I'm doing them. Just keep my my glutes tight, my core tight, and just as soon as my head gets like through the bar, just push it through. So that way I can complete it, and that's it. Now the last and final clip you're gonna see coming up is a grinder. So stay tuned for that. And thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for those of you commenting, liking my videos. Much appreciated. So that's it, and I will see you guys in the next one. Stay tuned for this grinder and the hate. Grinder.